nigga want, guy? Word up. Look out for the cops, though.
Cash food.
Word up. 2 for 5s over here, baby. Word up. 2 for 5s. Them niggas got garbage down the way. Word up.
Cash food's everything around me. Cream it.
Yeah. Check this old fly shit out. Word up.
Cash food's everything around me. Cream get the money.
Here we go. Check this shit. Yeah. I grew up on the crime side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job. Had second hands. Moms bounced on old men. So then we moved to Shaolin land. A young youth, you're rocking the gold tooth. Low goose. Only way I begin to G York was drug loot. And let's start it like this, son. Rolling with this one and that one. Pulling up gas for fun. But it was just
welcome back to the Why So Serious podcast. Brandon, Mike, and Devin are back for another episode. And today is actually the 25th anniversary of Enter the Woo, so that's why we played that song as the intro. But Devin, Mike, what's going on?
What's up?
What's up?
Chilling. First of all, I just want to talk about that because it was on Good Morning America this morning. And when I say I was uncomfortable and triggered by a lot of older white women with these Wu-Tang shirts on, bopping to this song like, you know, it was for them. I was triggered. I didn't like it, and I immediately averted my eyes. But I will also say those young black men age very well, because, yo, I was like, wow, they look really good. And then, side note, Inspector Deck looks like J.B. Smoove.
I didn't think I'd live in America where I would see the Wu-Tang Clan on Good Morning America.
Yeah, and that too.
So, that's pretty fucking amazing. And in itself, and I love Mike, that album.
But guess what, Mike? You're not even 25 yet, so this is something you have no idea about. You know about the Wu-Tang?
I know that some terrible person got the secret Wu-Tang album because Big Mike keeps talking about it. But I don't know what that is.
He does. So you never heard that song that we just played?
Never.
How have you never heard that song? Like in a movie?
I've heard of
or a TV show.
In a lot of other songs, but I never heard any of their music.
I can't believe you never heard Cream.
I mean,
that's crazy.
I really forgot, like, Ice Cream was a Raekwon song and not Wu-Tang song, because they had all them t-shirts with the different women, like Butter Pecan, Strawberry Chocolate Deluxe, and all that other joint. And I really forgot it wasn't even his song.
Yeah.
That is not a Wu-Tang song. That is definitely a Raekwon the Chef song.
But yeah, Wu-Tang's dope. They're still around, except for ODB. Rest in peace. All right, so
how do you feel about the Wakanda Forever shirts with the Wu-Tang symbol? I like it, but
I've never seen
it. I guess in Walmart. Oh, it's in Walmart. So like, if you go on the Walmart website, they got that joint. And they was on Teespring and everything, but like I dig that shirt, but I don't know if I could wear it because, you know, I don't really like New York shit. And even though the Wu-Tang is definitely cool, I don't really do that New York shit because I feel like you got to wear extra layers when you wear a Wu-Tang sign. Like you got to have either a beanie or like a bubble jacket or something shit. Like you just can't have no regular Wu-Tang shirt when it's not cold outside. So I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah, I'm about to look it up. I want to see that. But in the meantime, we were supposed to have Rashani on this weekend, but he has some computer problems, so it's just us three. We may get somebody jumping in the middle of the show. Maybe, maybe not. It's a surprise for Devin and Mike. They don't know. But let's start every week like we start. What'd you do nerdy, Mike?
I did a lot nerdy this week, actually. I bit the bullet and I did the free trial for DC Universe, and I thought I'd give it a try, which the trial's not up yet. And I started.
So can we talk about Titans?
Yeah, we can talk.
Are you all caught up?
Yeah, I just watched the most recent one today.
Oh, I didn't watch today, so don't tell me. But what'd you talk about up until Doom Patrol?
Okay, so I'm pleasantly surprised. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of hooked on it. I think that like. The story's good. Like, I honestly don't really have many problems with it other than Raven's acting is kind of bad, I think, at certain times. But I can't tell if I actually think it's bad or if I'm just so used to Raven being a certain way. Like, I don't know if you agree with me, but It's kind of a small thing, I would say. But all in all, I'm pleasantly surprised how the show's been. The Doom Patrol was my favorite episode so far.
Well, that was the best episode.
Yeah, I mean, it was. But the stuff before it wasn't bad either. Like, it was all set up. But the Doom Patrol episode was funny, and it was interesting to see, you know. And a problem that I have also with, like, a lot of this stuff, especially with Marvel, is that I already know so much about the characters going into it that it's pretty predictable. And I had never heard of the Doom Patrol, like, until this episode. And so I was like, for the first half, I was like, what is going on here? And then I looked it up a little bit, and I was like, this is cool. Like, it was very refreshing. And even like Hawk and Dove and stuff, too, I didn't really know about them. You didn't like them?
Oh, I hated every part of them in the show. It was so okay. So we might as well get into this. There's a good show there somewhere in that show.
I've heard you say it was good on the last podcast we did.
No, I said I was enjoying it more than I thought. However, it's not Dick Grayson, which still pisses me off. And there's things that I don't need. Like, I told you from the beginning, it's too much. It's too violent. It's overly violent for no reason. It's the Teen Titans. Why the fuck is blood splattered anywhere? Why do I need to know that Hank Hawk is stressed out? So in order to show me that he's stressed out, I have to see a scene where he can't get it up with Dove in the bed.
Oh, yeah. That was weird.
Why do I need to see that in my superhero show?
There's a few things. I just remembered a few things that I dislike. I dislike that Beast Boy, as far as he knows at least, can only turn into one thing.
Well, I like that. That's character development. If the idea of the show is that he's new, he's like not fully understood his powers yet, that would make sense. Now, if they tell me that that is his power and that all he can do is turn into a tiger, then yeah, that's absurd. That's the least of the problems with the show.
Okay, I agree with you, but it doesn't sound like, I don't know, there's a lot of episodes left. But
because the way they explained his powers is to say that he can manipulate his molecular DNA or something like that. So it would make sense that he would have to learn how to do that to other animals.
But the thing you're saying with Hawk and Dove is I think there's a lot of things in the show that they're leaving for late, like they're just setting a bunch of stuff up. Okay.
It wasn't no development though. They used Hawk and Dove as a plot point to throw Dove off the roof.
Yeah, but I have a feeling Hawk and Dove are going to be back.
Yeah, I'm sure they're going to be back at some point. That doesn't mean it made sense.
The other thing that I'm annoyed about, and you haven't got this far yet, but I think I can talk about it because we've talked about it before, and the next episode is literally called this.
Yes, I know. Jason Todd's in it. It makes no sense.
Yeah, So
I haven't even watched it. I'm going to watch it tonight, but yes, it's stupid. Also, the Doom Patrol was highly enjoyable. It makes me want to see that show because that shit looks like it's a lot of fun.
Aren't they doing a Doom Patrol show?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. It makes me want to see that.
Is the DC Universe stuff, Swamp Thing and Titans and the Doom Patrol, are they in the same universe?
I'm sure the Doom Patrol is, but I don't know about Swamp Thing. Here's another thing.
I want a shared universe for...
Starfire doesn't know shit about herself, right?
Yeah, so, I don't know what that is about either.
Which, that's fine. They're going to probably lead up to explain how that happened and why. That's fine. Here's the thing. She killed motherfuckers. She's wanted for murder.
Murder.
And Dick Grayson just walks into a police fucking perimeter with her like it's nothing. By the way, Dick Grayson is a detective in Detroit.
Well, wait. She killed people in overseas, in like Russia.
No,
in, like,
she
Siberia.
Also killed people here. Remember they got her on tape? They got her killing that family dude at the gas station?
That's weird, too. They're the nuclear family, which I read a little bit about. They're weird, but I think that's just how.
Also, Dick Grayson is a Detroit detective, okay? He's a detective in Detroit. He walks into a crime scene in Ohio by flashing his badge. How does that work? Oh, I'm a cop. Are you a cop in this city, in this town? No. This city? No. This county? No.
Yeah, but it's pertinent to his case because he's
state?
On the Rachel case.
No.
He's on the Rachel case.
I'm sorry. At what point did they say anything about how do they know that he's on the case?
Yeah, jurisdiction.
I'm sure they just didn't want to waste the time to explain it.
What? He just rolls up. What are you talking about? The crime just happened, Mike. And he rolled up in his car immediately after it happened. And then this dude just rolls up who you've never seen before and flashes his badge and you go, okay. And also, they basically turned Dick Grayson into Batman, which, you know.
No, he's trying to avoid becoming Batman.
No, he is Batman. What are you talking about? He's angry all the time. Yeah. He's brooding. He's bitter about his childhood. He's bitter about Bruce, who, honestly, if we're going to be honest, the dude, you got brought in by a billionaire. You were given a trust fund. You got to run around with him and have fun and do all types of shit. Why are you so mad? It's like...
Never got to worry about money ever in your life.
The show is...
asked Alfred for money in the first or second episode.
The show is not horrible. He asked for money to give to Hawk and Dove. The show is not bad. It's not a terrible show. But there's a ton of plot points. But the plot points can be explained. The bigger issue with the show is that it's... Who is your target audience? Like, the reason why the MCU is so successful is because they took 10 years to get new fans and new people into comic books who had never been into those characters before. And they built them up over years so that you could take an 8-year-old or a 10-year-old or a 12-year-old who saw Iron Man in 2008. And by the time Infinity War came out, they're 18, 20, and 22-year-olds grown-ups, and they're fully invested in these characters. And they grew up with these characters, and you've built a new generation of fans for these characters. How are you supposed to get 8, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11-year-olds to watch this shit with dudes having erectile dysfunctions, throwing women off of roofs, sticking fucking shooting grapple guns through people's eyes, like with gun blood splatter anywhere? Like, how are you supposed to develop new fans with that? How does that work? It doesn't work.
I don't have any answers for any of that stuff.
It doesn't work.
Have you seen it, Devin?
No, I am. I'm tapping out on that. I was trying to watch Flash, and it's good.
Flash is good this season. Really good.
When we get to that story, I was like, oh damn, that's crazy, because that's all I see him, and that's pretty cool.
What else, Mike? What else did you do?
I caught up on Arrow. I haven't started Flash yet.
Arrow's good. Flash is better than Arrow this year. Arrow's really good, though. All the shows have actually been really good this year. Supergirl's been my favorite, honestly. It's
Mike, did you watch that episode of Supergirl?
Yeah, I did, but I was a little confused because I haven't watched an episode of Supergirl since the first season.
I didn't need to watch it. It was right on the – it hit right on the head.
It was called Man of Steel, and it basically told you – it made an allegory of how well-meaning, quote-unquote, white people – get radicalized in real life. He basically, his racist dad is mad at the fucking aliens. He's like, there's nothing wrong with the aliens, but you know, they are kind of affecting your job. And then they get the inf metal and they build a factory, and now it has to cut into his budget, so he starts to get a little more animosity towards them. And then they have a strike because the other people are bigots and he tries to protect them. But the alien, who's just trying to protect himself, accidentally hurts him. And then that starts to turn the whole thing. And by the end, he's a full-blown MAGA Trump supporter.
Yep.
It was fucking amazing. It was amazing really good show.
Yeah, that was really good.
What else, Mike?
I watched Titans. Oh, I've been rewatching. So I've been exploring the DC Universe app, and I was just rewatching a bunch of old stuff. So I watched a bunch of my favorite episodes from the original Teen Titans.
Why didn't you just ask me for the password? You know I had to ask.
Well, I mean, it's a free trial, but also you were the one that told me that if something is struggling, I don't know, if you want to support something, then just buy it. Yeah,
that's true.
I learned that from you, so I just figured I would. I mean, also, it's the free trial, so I was like, if I don't like it, I'll just cancel it. So I got it on, I think, Thursday, so I have, like, most of the rest of next week to, like, enjoy it. So I might keep it. It's not like it's breaking my bank, but
the problem you were the one I have with it is that there's not as much comic books. But I do like watching the old movies and stuff, so I'm going to keep it. But I wish they had comic books like Marvel Unlimited. That would be dope.
I wish, yeah, and that's kind of my hope to get there. But so I don't know. It's the free trial, so I haven't actually paid for anything yet. So I'm just kind of seeing what it's about.
What do you think about Arrow?
Arrow, I like it so far. I will say I don't have any problems with Arrow. I haven't started The Flash yet, and I want him to get out of jail because.
So who's the new Green Arrow?
I feel like it's. Wait, I'm behind on Arrow by one episode, but I think it's Roy.
They haven't shown who it is yet.
I think it's probably Roy.
I think that's like too obvious. To I think it's William from the future.
See, that'd be. I kind of don't want them to do that.
They keep showing you William in the future.
That's true.
Are you? Or did you not pick that up?
No, I just feel like it's a little out there.
Don't but honestly, when they do those flashes with Roy on the island, the guy he's talking to is William from the future.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, I just want to make sure you were aware of that.
No, I'm aware. I just thought it was, I don't know. I thought they were doing that because Roy was the new, I don't know. I mean, also, when is the crossover? Because he's got to be out of jail and in the suit again by that time, right? Isn't that like their 10th episode, which is going to be like a month away?
I don't know when the crossover is. That's a great question.
Isn't the crossover like always when they come out of break? Like, so like around December or in January?
No, it's usually before, I think. The crossover this year is going to be, I mean, last year was great. I think this year is going to be even better.
Yeah, last year's crossover was awesome.
It was good. Yeah, I enjoyed it.
Devin, what have you done?
I watched Castlevania on Netflix, which I highly recommend everybody watch. It's two seasons, but maybe they're four episodes of the first season, and then so maybe 16 episodes or 30-minute episodes. You can get all the way through it and get caught up. It was a great series. It's just like, if you love the video game, if you ever played a video game, it's even better. They flesh it out and give it more. They give the story more legs. I enjoyed it a lot. So after that, I watched Naruto. I watched Naruto movie, and then I watched Boruto, the current episode this week. And then I started watching this anime called Angels and Devils. That's pretty cool. Got caught up on like Family Guy and Bob's Burgers. Also watched that episode of Supergirl that was awesome, and it made me watch the first episode of Supergirl. So I'm caught up on the first two episodes of Supergirl, and I'm going to catch up on that. Read a comic book. Been listening to a lot of audiobooks. I read an issue of the new Black Panther. That was really good. What else did I do? This listened to a lot of audiobooks and taking notes, and that's pretty much it.
Cool. I caught up on Amazing Spider-Man with Nick Spencer. That's pretty fucking good. It's actually funny as shit. They had an episode where like Spider-Man and Peter Parker got like split.
Oh wow.
So Peter's just normal, and Spider-Man is Spider-Man only, and he's out there fighting crime and shit. But like they also split like parts of their personality and their traits. So like he got the responsibility side, but Spider-Man didn't. So he's out there like fighting crime with this Sentinel and just destroying the fucking city and shit. It's pretty funny. I caught up on Justice League. It's out there, but I like it a lot. I caught up on Avengers. It's pretty damn good. Jason Aaron. Thor is fucking amazing. Like, that book is so good.
That's a new one, right?
Yeah, well, it's been going on for a while with Jason Aaron has. He was writing The Mighty Thor when it was Jane Foster and all the way through. But they basically have a part where it's like, like in the future with like Odin's son Thor versus fucking Doctor Doom with like ridiculous powers. It's fucking amazing. So that book is really good. I got some other books that I want to read. I got this book called Abby. It's an independent book. It's about this like black woman who's like a reporter in like 1970s Detroit. And it's kind of cool. I caught up on Titans. We talked about that.
Did you watch Daredevil yet?
Nope, not yet.
Yo, Daredevil's awesome.
Coffee, quiet. Me either. I'll watch Daredevil sometime soon. I need to get back to going to the movies, so I'm going to start this weekend.
I saw the girl in the spider's web today, and it was really good. I recommend it highly.
Yeah, so I'll probably go see that. I'm going to go see Bohemian Rhapsody, even though I heard it wasn't that good.
I hear different. People say they loved it.
I heard Widow was really good, so I'm going to go see that.
What about Nobody's Fool? You gonna give that love to Tyler Perry?
No.
Okay.
I will not be going to see Tyler Perry. I hope he does well though, but I won't be going to see it. And I've been playing No Man's Sky again. Mike, I got the submarine. It's pretty fucking cool.
Yeah, I'm about to get on when I get back, Brandon. We can play again.
So I'm probably gonna play.
Brandon and I play that together.
What do you guys think about Red Dead Redemption? Because I'm hearing that's all.
I want it. I haven't got it yet, but I want to get it over holiday. After I like, the only reason
Mike, that was the coolest white shit you ever said on this show. I want to get it over holiday. That is good.
Holiday
Mike.
Sales are like the best time to get anything now.
You just said holiday. That's what white people say. They say holiday. Like British people, they say over holiday, we're going
probably,
on holiday.
Yeah, I'll probably get it like maybe Black Friday if it's a sale or something.
I gotta wait. I'm not getting it now though because I'm about to Fallout 76 is almost out. Then I played the beta, but
okay. So let's get into. All right, let's get into this news and let's get some energy, Mike.
I got energy.
Let's get some energy. You should have took a shot. I know you got some liquor over there.
I do have a lot. My parents just brought me a bunch of stuff from Europe.
Wow. See, look, that's all I need. Like, this bring the privilege and the culture you bring to the show, Mike.
Nintendo pledges to remove controversial Native American reference in Super Smash Bros. Mike, are you aware of this?
Yeah, I saw that.
Nintendo plans to remove the controversial Native American reference to Super Smash Bros. Mr. Game & Watch character. Smash Bros. Ultimate Mr. Game & Watch character appeared with a feather on his head and torch in his hand during Nintendo's recent Japanese Super Smash
Bros. I think Bros. That was Ultimate in the original one, too.
Yeah, that's what I remember that.
That's been there for the last games.
It's a callback to the 1982 game Fire Attack, in which players controlled a cowboy who had to defend a wooden fort from Native Americans attempting to set it on fire. I always hate that shit. It's like they make the cowboys the baby faces when in actuality they were the heels.
Yeah.
Nintendo has been planning to distribute an update to Mr. Smash Bros. Ultimate to remove the feather from the silhouette of Mr. Game & Watch, which, you know, they should do that because nobody wants to see their culture turned into a caricature. So, that's fine, you know. Good on Nintendo. I'll talk about that last. Bethesda tries to set player expectations ahead of Fallout 76 beta. Mike, you played it. What'd you think?
It's kind of boring.
Really?
Yeah, but I think that's because the beta was slow. Like, they're clearly doing a lot of crash testing on servers because it's slow and laggy and the graphics suck. So I think that's a large part of my opinion. And I played every single time I played with my roommate. So, like, we were doing stuff together. But the beginning is the worst part. It's just boring at the beginning. And then as I got farther, it got more enjoyable. But I got to a point where the beta was so laggy and slow, I was like, I'm just going to wait for the full game. So I'm hoping. And I also know that there's going to be more content, or at least a little bit more, when the full thing comes out. So I'm going to see what happens. I'm willing to bet, though, I play it for like a couple weeks and then get bored.
Well, whenever either of you guys get done playing Spider-Man, just send it this way. Send it this way.
So are you going to buy it, Mike?
I pre-ordered it. That's why I have access to the beta. So, like, I'm going to play with my friends, like, when it's out, because my friends all got it, and we're all, like, the reason the other Fallout games are so good is there's a lot to do, and then there's a lot of story, and there's a lot of different stories. It's an RPG, like, I'm sure you guys have played similar. Mm-hmm. So, there's all, like, you could play the game for a month straight and just do something different every day. But, like, this one, they were, like, we're going to not put any NPCs in it at all. And except for the enemies, right? So, like, you can't go to a store and trade with somebody. You can't, there's not no people to give you side quests. You get it all from a computer, which is going to get repetitive. And I'm like, they really wanted to push, they made it very clear that every single person you meet in the game is real. And I was like, well, that's kind of a dumb idea because it's going to feel repetitive after a while. And then if there's no NPCs, there's only so much you can do with missions and stuff that are not NPC driven. So, like, they're going to get boring. So you really have to hope that what you're doing with your friends is fun, because I just feel like it's going to get really repetitive is what I'm saying.
Are you getting it on the PC?
Right now, I have it on the Xbox because all my friends are playing, and then I'm probably going to get it on the computer when it goes on sale. That's usually what I do. Because I prefer playing on the computer. But if it's not fun, though, like if I feel like it's really boring, I might not even, you know, get it again. If you get it, though, I'll get it in a heartbeat.
Okay, I feel like I'm not getting it, though.
I'm definitely not getting it.
I just don't play Fallout. I don't know. I played it one time, and it was cool, but I feel like they're all the same.
Yeah, that's how I feel. But
no, I played all of them. They're different. Like, I like them a lot, but I'm just saying, you know, I don't know. I mean, I'll let you know if I think it's good, and I'll probably bug you until you get it, so we'll see what happens.
I still got to get a fucking Nintendo Switch, yo. That's
I promise I won't bug you and beg you to get it, though, unless I actually
I'm getting I have Nintendo Switch, and I can't wait for Super Smash Brothers and Pokemon.
Yeah, I need that Pokemon shit. I really do.
Spider-Man is shattering PlayStation records. Surprise. The game which hit...
I got a question for y'all. Yeah. Okay, so in your opinion, who's more popular? Is Spider-Man more popular than Batman?
Yes, he's the most popular superhero there is by numbers.
I can't disagree with him.
By merchandise, toys, all that, he's the most popular superhero we have. The game, which hit the PlayStation 4 on September 7th, received mostly positive reviews, also generated high dollar sales in its launch. Sales in its launch than any other game this year, placing it as the third best selling game in 2018. Perhaps most telling fans of Marvel game Spider-Man is NPD analysis, which shows that Marvel Spider-Man achieved launch month sales 37% higher than the combined launch month sales of all other Spider-Man games released since the NPD group began tracking in 1995. So yeah, Spider-Man's doing fucking great, and it should be because it's a great game.
That's great. So like, okay, so it's similar to Arkham, but it's Spider-Man.
Yes.
So
it's very similar to Arkham.
Do you like? What would you guys say makes it more fun than Arkham?
I didn't say it was more fun than Arkham. It's about equal. Do you think
it's equal?
But you do. It's just different animations. You could do so much more shit with Spider-Man.
Yeah, he has more like the freedom to navigate the city is probably the best part of the game.
Okay, and do you guys think that another Avenger or another Marvel character could carry a video game by themselves?
Yes, but it wouldn't sell as much as Spider-Man because they're not Spider-Man.
It might now if it has the Insomniac thing on it. It might.
Mm-mm. Spider-Man is the name.
What characters do you think could carry their own video games and do well?
Daredevil.
No, absolutely not.
Yes.
No. Nobody's buying a Daredevil game unless it's great. Like, great, great. And it had to be great before people go out and buy it. They're not going to buy it off the strength of Daredevil. I mean, at this point, Iron Man could. He couldn't 10 years ago, but now, because of the movies, he's far more popular.
Mm-hmm.
And with a video game, you could do all types of crazy animations and shit to make Iron Man even cooler than he is.
Even cooler, yeah. But you have to get Robert Downey on board if he's not.
Oh yeah, if it's a Robert Downey character, people would definitely be on board. I mean, there's a lot. I mean, there's a lot of Marvel people that can have video games, but Spider-Man is just the best to do it for a number of reasons. But most importantly, just name recognition and people, how much people love the character. Similar to how Batman, you could probably do a Superman game, but it's not going to be as good. Nobody as a wants Batman to game.
Yeah, I'm not playing a Superman game. I don't even think Superman's villains are as good. I mean, Lex Luthor is awesome. He is the best.
I mean, Lex Luthor's a pretty damn good villain.
But he doesn't have that gravitas for me, because you have to know who Lex Luthor is. You have to get his backstory. You got to see all the evil shit he's done before the Superman to be like, oh, this really drives it. He's really evil.
Well,
he's
not really in 2018. Lex Luthor is basically smart Trump. He hates the immigrant, and so he uses all this propaganda to try to get the world to turn against immigrants. He's a rich businessman. He ran for president. He won.
Yep.
The only difference is he's much more competent than Trump, so which makes him even more terrifying.
Very, very good assessment of that whole situation you just broke down. Very good.
NPR did a story on what I've been talking about for a long time. Right-wing hate groups are recruiting video gamers.
Oh yeah, I saw you shared. Did you share that or something?
Yeah, not a surprise for me. Very aware of this. It makes total sense. If you think about the whole Gamergate thing, that fits right in with the right-wing propaganda. John, a father of two in Colorado, had no idea what his 15-year-old son had gotten into until one night last year when John walked into his home office. We're not using his last name to protect his son's privacy. John saw a large pile of papers face down next to his printer. He turned them over and found a copy of a notorious neo-Nazi propaganda book. It's the white culture in trouble. We are under attack by Jews, blacks, every other minority. It was scary. It's absolutely frightening to even see that in my house. I was shaking like, what in the world is this and why is this in my house? John confronted his son. I was through the roof, and then I went back into my room. I was crying. I felt like a failure that a child I had raised had become remotely interested in that sort of stuff. Almost every teen plays video games. 97% of boys, according to Pew Research, 83% of girls. Increasingly, these games are played online with strangers, and experts say that while it's by no means common online games and that associated chat rooms, live streams, and other channels have become one avenue for recruitment by right-wing extremist groups. At the time, John's son liked playing first-person shooter games, of course, like Counter-Strike, Global Offense. Games like these are multiplayer. You must form teams with friends or strangers you can chat in the game over voice or text or a separate chat room. Some of these are hosted by sites like Discord that make it easy for anyone to create a private chat. John knew his son was spending time playing video games and chatting either out loud or over text, but there were no obvious red flags. There wasn't anything obvious to me at first because it was common. This is norm for kids. Instead of hanging out at the drive-in, they're all online, he said. Yeah, it's exactly this way, John says. I started hanging out with avowed white supremacists. These people became his son's friends. They talked to him about the problems he was having at school and suggested some of his African-American classmates as scapegoats. They also keyed into his interest in history, especially military history, and in Nordic mythology. Above all, they offered his membership in a hierarchy, whites against others. He started to feel like he was in on something. He was now in the in crowd with these guys. It provided some structure and the identity that he was searching for at the time. John learned his son had been drawn into the conversation. At least one group that was Southern Poverty Law Center calls a Nazi terrorist organization. He searched online for help and found a man named Christian Piccolini. Piccolini runs the Free Radicals Project, which he calls a global prevention network for extremism. He's a reformed skinhead himself. 30 years ago, when I was involved in the white supremacist movement, it was very much a face-to-face interaction, he says. You know, you had to meet somebody to be recruited, or you had a pamphlet or a flyer put on your car. But today, he says, it's much more common for extremists to initially reach out online, and that includes over kids' headsets during video games. Piccolini describes the process. Why are they talking to this dude? Well, typically, they start out with dropping slurs about different races or religions and kind of test the waters. Once they sense that they've got their hooks in them, they ramp it up, and they start sending propaganda links to other sites so that they start talking about these old kind of racist anti-Semitic tropes. That's also what Joan Donovan has seen. She's a media manipulation research and data researcher. So it goes on and on a little bit more. But
you know that guy has his own show on MSNBC?
Who does?
That guy you're talking about that group to try to transform people's mind process that used to be that earned their life. Like, he has a whole show on MSNBC.
Who does?
Piccolini, dude.
No, he doesn't.
He does.
Are you kidding me? Christian Piccolini?
Yes. He has a show on MSNBC. That's like, I was like, yo, that sounds like that show. Because he used to be a Nazi. He used to be in a Nazi hate group, yeah.
Oh, he's a dude that used to do it, and now he's good. Now he's trying to be a better person.
Yeah.
And so, oh, so he's talking about how it happened, how it worked.
Yeah.
Okay. I see. Mike, you play a lot of video games. What do you think about this? Have you seen any of this in any of your chat rooms?
I haven't seen it personally, but I don't really talk to people online because it's a terrible experience pretty much every single time because they're just the worst. I mean, like, so I play one game I play that I would never really talk about on here. Is my best friend and I, we play Rocket League. Have you guys ever heard of Rocket League?
Yes.
Yes.
So we play that a lot. We play it actually like every night, like before bed. And it's a pretty, like, you know, half the time people are pretty good. And like if you're, you know, but the other half the time, whether you're winning or losing, there's just people out there who's just trying to make your life terrible, like over the chat. So I kind of try to stay away from it. I've never seen it. It doesn't surprise me that it happens, but like, people feel so powerful behind, like, a headset or a keyboard, you know? Especially when you're in a quick, like, a few-minute game. You'll never see this person again. Like, nothing's off the table. Like, I've seen every kind of slur. Horrendous insult and slur, and you know, it's like people, you know, I mean, it doesn't surprise me that these people go on there because there's really, it's impossible to track. There's barely a penalty, you know, for this type. There's no penalties really. You could say whatever you want. You're going to get away with it. And so, you know, I mean, that doesn't surprise me at all.
Basically, this video games and YouTube is the way they radicalize young white men. You used to hear the thing, well, when all these old racist people, they die off, things are going to be a lot better.
Yeah.
And maybe that could have happened. But now that you have the internet, and you have YouTube, and you have video games, and you come in and you relate the things that they like to these hate groups and hate speech and all these things that you hate, it's easy to get these young white men who are already angry about shit to direct their anger towards black and brown people, women specifically. The Gamergate whole thing was really started about how much they hated women, and then it turned into other things along with that, so...
Brandon, did you see what that president said to that young black woman today?
What do you mean? He said it to three black women.
Yeah. I mean, today. I was just talking about today.
He called April Ryan nasty and a loser who's been doing news for like 25 years.
And then, yeah.
He called Kamichi.
Lou Alcindor's, I mean.
A racist for asking him a simple question. Like, I mean, you know, it's for the record. That's what
and he called Abby dumb today. Stupid.
Well, he said that was a stupid question. He's like, I watch you all the time. You ask a lot of stupid questions.
Stupid questions, yeah.
So.
Yeah.
It's horrible, but I try not to get angry at Trump. We had a win on Tuesday, so I'll take it.
Still some wins in progress, too, because we're going to have a lot of runoffs.
Yep. The Flash, Jesse L. Martin, taking a leave of absence from the show. So, if you've been watching the show, one thing that you'll notice is that in almost all his scenes, he's been sitting down. And so, I didn't notice that until I was listening to one of my favorite podcasts, Super Tuesday, on the MTR Network, and D-Palm pointed out just like, hey, every scene, Jesse L. Martin is like sitting down. He's sitting at a couch, or he's laying in bed, or he's sitting on a step. He's not walking. He's not doing anything. So that tells me that I was like, something must be wrong with him. And yeah, apparently he has a back injury. And he's going to be out for a little while. So I just hope he gets healthy because that dude is an acting machine. And
it really is.
He still gets those great black fatherhood moments on the show. He still gets those great moments on the show. But it's not the same when Joe West is not in action.
Yeah. I feel you.
Damn. Hold on.
Look at you getting your black dad on right now. I love it.
Oh, no, I'm not. My cord just got caught up in my chair.
Oh.
All right. Kevin Feige talks about Disney Play, which is going to be an amazing streaming service because they're doing what you should do as a streaming service. Build content at the release. Don't release some shit with one thing and tell me all these other good things that I want to see are going to come. Release it with a bunch of stuff. If you take anything from Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon, they flood you with original content to the point that you cannot consume at all. And so it makes you want to keep it because there's so much good shit you want to get to, that, but you'll never ever get to it all. But you keep keeping it. You keep keeping it. DC Universe didn't do that. They gave you Titans, and they have to release it week by week because there's nothing else on the app to keep you there. I mean, you can go back and watch old movies, but is that worth paying $7.99 every month? No, you probably want some original content, so hopefully they'll get that fixed. But they already announced the Loki and Scarlet Witch show.
So now is that one show, or is that this? Both of them are getting their own show?
No, it's two shows. A show focused on Loki and Scarlet Witch, with news of a third miniseries featuring a team-up between Falcon and Winter Soldier.
That'd be cool.
I think Disney... So Kevin Feige said...
It's Disney, so are we getting Mackie and an old boy to play Bucky?
Yes, they're getting all the movie actors and actresses.
that's hot.
We're going to get Papa Doc.
Yeah.
I think Disney Play is something that we're going to be adding content to, which is exciting. I love your analogy with the campfire, right? As many people as you can get around the campfire and tell stories, explained Feige in a roundtable discussion with the Hollywood Reporter. Campfires can be different. We're going to tell stories from the streaming service, for the streaming service, that we wouldn't be able to tell in a theatrical experience. A longer form narrative. That's what comics are. It's about as long form narrative as exists, but also maintaining the theatrical experience. I can't wait for that shit. Mike, are you excited for Disney Play?
Yeah. Do we know when it's coming out?
No, but it should be coming out soon, and they said it's going to be price competitive or lower than Netflix.
Sometimes next year, sometime next year.
You get the Star Wars live action show, a Star Wars animated show, three Marvel shows, a Pixar show. Like, it's going to be fucking great.
It's going to be beyond belief. Yo, that's crazy.
Are you guys in for True Detective Season 3?
Never seen it.
What was 2 about? Because I saw 2,
and I don't remember because it was a couple years ago. But Season 3 has my dude, Mahershala Ali.
Hey, I'm going to see that green book. I am going, because he is acting his ass off, and Viggo is the man. So I'm definitely here for True Detective if he's in it.
Yeah, so, yes, trailer came out, so it's in the show notes. You can check it out. Let's see, what else we got here? The Purge TV show got renewed for a second season. So I meant to watch it because I thought it was going to be good. And now that it got renewed, tells me that
people liked it.
The adaptation is currently USA's most popular drama series, averaging 2.3 million viewers per episode across its first season. With 1.2 million is key demographic, 18 to 49. So I'll probably check that out. Hopefully it's on demand somewhere. I think it's only like 10 episodes for the first season. No, 12 episodes. So, yeah, I'm going to watch that. I'm glad it's coming back because I like that last Purge movie a lot. Rick Grimes is off The Walking Dead. And they're making some Walking Dead movies. So they really just tricked you. I'm glad I stopped watching that show 2 years ago. Mike, you got anything to say about The Walking Dead?
I used to watch it. I kind of stopped. I follow the news with it, but I haven't watched an actual episode since Negan killed all those people.
Shout out to Rod and Karen from the Black Guy Tips, because I don't have to watch the show because they do recap episodes.
Yeah, I stopped watching, listen to their recaps because I didn't watch the show. But I should probably just listen to their recaps because I don't watch the show.
Right, that is exactly what
I think
what
I'm about
I did.
To start doing that again. All right, let's see, movie news. So, the dude who plays Cyclops said, "You should expect a much more mature Cyclops in X-Men: Dark Phoenix." Fuck this movie.
Like,
next.
Yeah,
let's get into some good news. Super Mario Brothers animated movie is in development.
Yo, who's the studio? What studio?
Illumination.
Oh, they're good. Yeah.
Mike, are you gonna go see a Super Mario Brothers movie, animated movie? No. You're not gonna see it.
Are you not going to see?
Did you see the last one?
No. Okay, listen, Mike. Come on. Why would you even bring that up? Are you kidding me? That is nothing compared to what this is going to be. Let me tell you some of the movies Illumination made. All right, you ready, Mike?
Mm-hmm.
They made Despicable Me, Despicable Me 2, Despicable Me 3, The Lorax, Sing, The Secret Life of Pets, Minions, and the new Grinch movie.
That's what I said. I'm going to see Grinch. I was going to go see it today. I was going to go ahead and steal a movie, you know what I mean? And go ahead and go to, after I came out of the girls in the spider web, I was going to go ahead and hit the Grinch movie. But I had a big sushi lunch. So I was like, oh, man, I'm going to go home and take a nap. But I'm here for that Grinch. I know it's going to be better than the original.
Fuck no, it's not. Are you kidding me?
Oh, it's going to be cute. I mean, yeah, you're right.
You think it's going to be better than the original?
Maybe comparable. We'll say comparable.
I love that Grinch movie.
You can never get his evilness over like you can now. Like, his evilness back then was just pure. And now it's, you're right. I apologize. I misspoke.
Shrek and Puss in Boots are being rebooted by Despicable Me director.
I don't know that I want to see another Puss in Boots movie. Even though he's good. Antonio Banderas is good.
Mike, are you into Shrek?
I don't know why it needs rebooted, but I mean, I'll watch it.
Shrek is more in your demographic. You were a kid when Shrek came out.
They got four movies. Shrek. They had four movies, yo. Was it four or three?
The last two were terrible. The first two were good.
I haven't seen the last two.
They don't even watch them. They're bad. That's not even my opinion. They're just no one likes them. No. I don't think I ever met anybody.
Justin Timberlake was in that third one, right?
I don't even know. Oh yeah, he played
King Arthur. Yeah.
Let's see.
If Eddie Murphy's there,
rewatch Shrek though, like the original one and even the second one, there's a lot of mature themes in there that you just don't see as a child.
Oh no, I saw them all. So because I was older. Older. Yeah.
I'm not sure who in the world asked for this, but John Cena. Somebody, people online are trying to speculate that John Cena is going to be the next Captain America.
I will stop. I will not watch
There's
that. There's
no
stop.
Possible way Marvel does that. Are you kidding me? John, they're going to follow up Chris Evans with John Cena.
Yeah, not even a thing. My man is growing his hair though. You know what I mean? Like his hair looks good.
Yes, he's growing his hair, but get the fuck out of here. John Cena is Captain America. What a fucking joke! Oh, because he posted on Twitter a fucking picture of the fucking shield. Get out of here.
Is Wolverine gonna be in that movie? Because that's what I mean.
Get out of here. Fuck you, John Cena. You're not doing Captain America.
You don't like John Cena?
I love John Cena. He's not following my man Chris Evans though. Come on. The GOAT. Austin Powers 4 is looking good, Mike Myers says.
I heard Mike Myers is a terrible person to work with.
Why?
I just read, apparently he's very difficult on set.
So you're saying you wouldn't go see Austin Powers 4?
No, I would see it. I'm just saying I feel bad for the people he's got
to
work with.
It would be interesting to see how they do an Austin Powers movie in 2018.
Yeah, because you can't say those things. A lot of those themes can't be.
So I'd be interested to see how they do that.
I'd be interested to see what stars they get, because they usually get a lot of good cameos and big stars to actually play in these movies. Like John Travolta
was in one.
That is correct. But John Travolta was in one too.
If you tell me I'm getting a Dr. Evil movie, you may get me there.
You know, I would pay money for Dr. Evil. I will definitely be there for that.
Because that dude is funny.
That's funny. Funny.
And then lastly, Mike, I'll let you go on this one because I'm pretty sure you have a lot to say. Did you see Ama Umamu? The
what?
Fucking spaceship.
No.
Okay.
What?
Mike. Okay. This is why I send you the fucking show notes so you can read them before the show.
I read them. I didn't click on any of the links.
Oh, what's the fucking point? Mike, look
you
at should, the...
I already know what you're... What
Mike,
most
look
of
at the chat and click on the link I just sent. Look at the Skype chat.
Okay. All
right, click on that. Harvard scientists, this has been in all the newspapers, are speculating that an alien spaceship has come through our solar system.
How do I get to the show? Oh, here it is.
Come on, Mike. You got it, yo. You're going to have to speed read, yo, because it's good.
Oh. Oh, I did see this.
So, what do you think?
I think it's bullshit.
You don't think that's a spaceship?
Damn, Mike.
That is an asteroid. My friend works for NASA. We talked about this. It's an asteroid.
But it says the astronomers thought it might be an asteroid, but unlike the millions of known asteroids in our solar system, this one was traveling so fast, more than 70,000 miles per hour, that it couldn't be captured by our sun's gravity. The scientists reasoned. For reference, Voyager 1, the spacecraft that's currently leaving our solar system, is traveling at around 35,000 miles per hour. So this this was traveling way faster than any asteroid they've ever seen before.
It's an asteroid. It's got to be.
Come on, Mike.
I thought you were pro-alien.
Oh. I am pro-alien.
Oh, you're not.
It even looks like an asteroid.
It looks like it could be a spaceship too.
Although that's probably, is that even it? If it's too fast to capture it.
No, the sun's gravity.
That's an artist's concept of it too. So you don't even know.
Yeah, that's not what it looks like. You don't even know.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm about it, but I also don't want to die. So.
Well, they could come in peace. They could come in peace.
They could, or they couldn't.
But I think, you know,
I'm pretty sure if they could reach us, they have way more tech than we do.
If they have this, if they have the technology to travel that fast, what do they need us for?
I mean, the same reason.
It's a scout.
They just want to meet new civil. Maybe they think they're the only life in the universe, like we think. Well, I don't think that, but
I don't think that either.
I think they know, but we don't know, you know. And they have come to, you know, give us technology because. Apparently, we've had visitors before, guys. We had to. Because these pyramids, they can't do that math. We can't do that math now. So,
Mike thinks the Egyptians did the pyramids.
And somebody helped them. Somebody gave them that math.
Mike, do you think aliens helped Egyptians build the pyramids?
No. No, I do not.
Where did this internet come up? You know what I mean? Like, yo, people's been here. Like, you got to think about it, Mike. Like, the technological advances we've made in the last 50 years.
In my days in architecture school, I studied a lot of history. It is quite possible. I mean, mathematicians the Egyptians helped create math. It's not so hard to believe that they had the skills.
Who gave them the knowledge?
They discovered it.
You don't want to believe, Mike.
Math is based off of logic.
It sounds real good, Mike. I'm just saying you don't want to believe. You just don't.
No, but I'm saying before there were mathematicians, there were people who studied logic, the Greek thinkers, right? Like,
correct.
This all started from somewhere, and then it just builds up slowly. So people have ideas. People try to have better ideas than the person who thought of the first idea. It's like the iPhone and the Android, right? They compete with each other, and then it's just like back then. You don't have Apple and Android, but you have Socrates and you have.
Aristotle,
yeah, like, you know, you just compete and then they improve, right? So the technology gets better because we have competition. The math gets better because you have competition. It's like, it's not,
it seems like, it sounds, believe, man.
It sounds, for people like us who have all this technology to help us, it sounds like it's impossible for the Egyptians to create something of that magnitude. But back then, you know,
look, I'm not saying they weren't capable. I'm saying they were given the tools by visitors. That is what I'm saying to you, Michael.
So, Mike, do you think we've had visitors from not on this planet or on Earth before?
I wouldn't be surprised. And here's the other thing, though, as a point in Devin's argument, I will say this. At some point in the ancient days, right, something had to have happened to get people to start believing in all these different types of gods, right? Like, there was like 12 in each. Now people really believe in one. Like, no one really believes in the different gods with different powers. And I think at some point that, like, slowly switched. But there had to have been a reason for that at the very beginning.
You're talking about white people. That's what you're talking about. You're talking about white people. Yeah, we got to stop talking
point is, like, way back in ancient times when they believed in, like, 12 different gods, each with different powers.
Yeah.
I want to know where that started. And that's where I give a point where I would put something into Devin's art. Like, I would give
what happened to the Mayans? What happened to the Mayans, you know?
So, Mike, what's more likely, okay? What's more likely, that there are aliens walking the Earth right now or that there are people walking the Earth right now with superpowers?
That's a tough question.
I got to feel like they're aliens.
It depends what you define as a superpower.
Like shit that we read in comic books.
But like technologically or like mutatively?
No, like naturally, mutatively, or they were naturally like metahuman shit.
Probably aliens.
So you don't think metahumans could exist?
I think they can.
I mean, people have extraordinary adaptations. And I mean, you can call them mutations if you want to, but they had a show.
So do you think Usain Bolt is a real life metahuman?
No.
Is that the reality version of a metahuman?
I just think he's the best.
No, but like, if nobody's ever ran that fast before, Michael, like, what are we saying?
That he's the fastest man in the world.
No, ever.
Ever, okay. So
that's his superpower is speed.
So he might be a real life metahuman.
Yep.
I mean, I guess. But I would say if you think there were aliens walking the earth now, they'd have been here for so long, I think.
You can call them our geniuses, you know, and they sprinkle their knowledge and their tech, and we just come to think of the people, maybe Elon Musk is an alien.
No, I think that's a conspiracy theory. You're starting to get into the whole lizard people thing.
No.
What is this lizard people thing?
You never heard of this?
No, what are you talking about?
People from
I first discovered show. This on a Megabus, and I met a gentleman. His name was Lagic, Lhagic. He had a business card.
Thank you.
He sat next to me on the Megabus, and we were talking, and he had this book, and it was bound in snakeskin. And he was like, you should check this book out. And there was context to this, I forget. But I opened the book, and it was written in some foreign language and had pictures of lizard people. And basically the premise is that there are some people out there who believe that lizard people have been living in the Earth's crust for all of our human existence, and they have learned to – they're basically Skrulls from Marvel. They've learned to look like people, and so like the theory is like,
oh, get the fuck out of here.
Donald Trump and all the other – a bunch of other like leaders of the world are actually lizard people. You can Google it right now.
I'm not Googling that bullshit.
Yeah, that no.
Are you kidding me? That's a legit thing people believe.
Yes.
Yeah. They have. Like,
I mean, it's mostly a joke on the internet, but people believe it. Devin, you've heard of it, right?
Yeah. No, like.
So a show okay, so this might be the, flat Earth, like flat Earth theory.
Yeah. Exactly. It's like that. Not a lot of people believe it, but there are people like this guy on the bus. His name was Lagic. He believed me. I mean, he believed it.
Literally, TBS made a show about it.
He was also a TV producer who made music and film, and I was like, I find that hard to believe, sir.
I mean, you took the business card, though, Mike, so I mean...
I still have it somewhere.
I mean, I feel like we gotta Google this Lagic guy, you know? But yeah, TBS literally did a show, like, two summers ago.
Also...
Wyatt Snack was the star of it, so it was cool.
You should probably shout out to the last podcast on the left. I love that show. Devin, I went back and listened into the archives. Guess what? They did a three parts on the murders of Biggie and Tupac. The recent one they did was this guy named Peter Curtin, who was like a serial killer in pre-World War I Germany. And he used to like, he would like fucking stab people with scissors and kill them and then like masturbate over them. And then stick the scissors in their head so blood comes out, and then drink the blood out of their head. Like, that's all gross. Types of crazy shit. Like, he was an evil son of a bitch. That show was so fucking good. I love that fucking show. I've just been going back listening to all these old episodes that I missed to catch up. So,
randomly, I was having a conversation with one of my cohorts at work, and we were talking about Star Wars, and he was in the military, and... he fucked Star Wars up for me as far as the Imperial uniform. It's based off a Nazi uniform, guys.
Yeah, that's the whole point.
I know, but I was like, you know, he started pointing out all the details, and I was like, oh, yeah. Because I knew that's what it's about, but still, like, oh.
It's not a bad thing. They're the bad guys.
But then he was showing... he was showing me the pictures, and then he was telling me the pilots, and even the TIE fighters. They have the German fucking little whistle blowhorn thing when they're diving down. Now, that was on a German plane, and I didn't even know that shit.
Like, no, that's not true. I've seen the sound effects guy for Star Wars did a video on how he makes all the sounds.
No, but I'm not saying it's that sound, but that's where they got that from. The
oh, idea. Yeah, but that's not a bad thing. I mean, they're the bad guys.
Yeah, that's the point. It's great.
That's the point, yeah. But I was just like, oh, damn. Like, that's right. I didn't know they was. It was so, like, yeah. It was so, like.
It's not like they're glorifying it or anything, though.
Sure. Yeah, but, I mean, so, yeah.
Anything else you guys got?
Breaking Bad. Did I say this last time? Breaking Bad is getting a movie.
You mean Walking Dead?
And Breaking Bad.
Breaking Bad's getting a movie? Oh, maybe I need to watch the show then.
No, the show's great. You actually should watch the show. You never seen it?
No, nah. No, I know it's great, so I will watch it at some point.
I'm not. I mean, it is what it is.
It's great, Devin.
You no, the first couple episodes, no, I mean, again, it's cool. It's just not for me. There's some slow episodes in there.
Well, yeah, the first season is slow, but
yeah,
everything else is fantastic. Once he becomes like Heisenberg.
Don't start talking about it. We'll talk about that later. Charmaine Ben said this. So should I hit her up? Do you guys want to do this Green Lantern review like next week, maybe?
No, they went to LA Comic Con, yo. That's pretty cool.
That is cool. Y'all want to do this Green Lantern review?
I don't want to watch it, but I'll do the review.
No, you have to watch it.
I'll watch it. I just don't want it. Is it on DC Universe?
I don't know. If not, we can get it by other means.
I'm not buying it, nor am I renting it.
That's why I said other means.
Mike. Not that this show condones pirating illegal.
Mike, we got it. Other means.
All right. Thank you guys for listening. We will be back next week. We should have another guest back next week.
Wu-Tang Forever.
Wu-Tang Forever is Wu-Tang Day. Remember, November 9th is Wu-Tang Day from here on out. But you can find us on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, anywhere you get your podcasts at. Leave us a 5-star review. It helps us out a lot. We'll be back next week, hopefully with another episode and a Green Lantern review. We'll take the bullet for you. So thank you guys for listening, and we'll talk to you later. Sick ass click and went